welcome back to Dilly's ABV. Today, we are going to, fingers crossed, get the bottom end of this engine put back together. To do this, we're going to need to clean the threads on the crankshaft for the primary bolt that we messed up last time. Replace the cam chain, torque the primary, install the clutch assembly, install the side cover, and reinstall the brake pedal and kickstart. No worries, I have faith that it'll work out though. Okay, so the first issue is the die is too big for the handles I have. I found a pipe that kind of fits, so I can cut off the end, thread some bolts, and then make some sort of a handle for it. That should work. Looking at it, there's not a good way to make a handle for this pipe because the handles would hit other parts of the bike. So I found a socket that is a better fit overall, and it is soft steel, so I can drill and tap a hole in it, allowing for a bolt that'll hold that die in place. I did tap this off camera because the socket is pretty hard and the tap was frustrating me. I'll just leave it at that. Using the socket, I'm able to adapt it way out away from the bike and use a ratchet as the handle, so that's kind of convenient. The next trick is to getting it to clean out the threads properly. Well, that should about do it. Make sure if you do this, clean out any of the shavings. Leaving any little piece will wreak havoc on the motor's internals later on. Now that it's rethreaded, the die should go on easily. But it doesn't. I don't like the way that feels at all, or looks. Trying the bolt, I really didn't like that either. I can tell something is still not right. And upon looking closer, the threads were cut diagonal, meaning the nut would not seat properly against the primary gear. To prevent anyone from knowing how human I am, off camera I worked on this for a good half hour to get the die to thread straight. But with much frustration, persistence, and name calling, we got it. Now we can move forward again with the final assembly. The new chain on, the primary gear installed, the washer, then the nut. We were ready to torque it down. I added some Loctite just to give it a little extra holding power considering the condition of the threads, and then using the new beam style torque wrench, I tightened it. I used some masking tape to mark the minimum torque, and I got to the minimum and I was happy. I'm not going to push my luck and go more than I absolutely need. I feel so much relief that I was able to get that done. Now I can throw on the clutch basket. First, I need to lube everything, even under the bushing. I tend to get a little excited with this stuff. Okay, I gotta be careful, work it until all the gears line up and it slides into place. Then the washer and the nut. Let's see, the torque is 40 to 60 Newton meters. I'm using the gears to hold the clutch basket while I torque it, and it's kind of fun to watch the bike sink and then reverse spin out. I now realize the proper use for my clutch pliers. I gotta pull all the discs back out, and with those out, I can attach the pliers and use a foot peg bolt to prevent it from spinning. Oops, wrong side. Okay, that's good. Now I can put the discs back in. While I'm thinking about it, I should check the specs on the friction plate as well. My OCD kicked in. I must have them all lined up. Now for the outer portion. What is the torque on these? Oops, did you catch that? I didn't bend over the washer for the inner nut. Back off it all comes. Using a chisel and a hammer, I can carefully bend them over. Tapping it in a pry bar motion seems to fold over better without doing any damage to the basket. Okay, now back to where I was. They don't specify a torque. These are M6 bolts into aluminum, so I will go about snug. Now for the case. I have not cleaned it yet, so that's the first thing. And then, because I did not order a new gasket, I'm going to use RTV on both sides of the old gasket to make sure we get a good seal. Hold me close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't want to waste what's left.
storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. And on we'll go through the wastelands, through the highways. And on.
Let's see if we can get this on without making a huge mess. Close. Something somewhere is not lining up. Maybe the clutch? Also, thinking if I put the gasket on the bike, the alignment pins will hold it in place better. Okay, so I've got to make sure the clutch gear is facing the right way and then work it back on. Okay, I felt it engage and settle into place. Now I can use the drill and put these in a lot more quickly. Be sure to use the lowest setting if you do this. Do not over tighten them. That would be another mess. Okay, so now I realize that marking the clutch lever when removing it was pointless. It's just a gear and can line up pretty much wherever depending on how you do it when you're putting it together. Okay, I gotta clean the oil cap and then that can go back together. I'm using the K&N 136 filter, if you wanted to know. So now on for the kickstart. When I took this off, I saw it was super nasty and it seemed incomplete. Cleaning out these pieces is a bit of pain because they're so small, but it'll be nice in the end. A little grease to keep everything moving as well, and then there's a spring with two ball bearings that go in it. I'm missing one of them. I thought I could get a ball bearing out of another bearing, but they were too small. A BB from my BB gun was a little on the small side as well, but it was close enough to work. Then, on top of everything else, the screw was boogered, so I had to replace it with another one from one of my bolts bins. Let's put it this way, off camera, I was able to get it all together. It just took a little digging. Okay, so back to the bike. Let's start with the brake pedal. A little grease for smooth operation. Although I saved the pins, they're not going back in so well. So, time to pull out my cotter pin kit. Oh, so much better. I'll put a link to the kit that I used in the description. It's nice to have handy when you need it. Time for the brake tools again. Totally worth having. I'll put a link to them as well. That makes this job so much easier. Okay, now for the kickstart to go on the bike. Stubborn to come off, stubborn to go back on. Except this time I have a hammer. Ha ha. Now that I'm done with this side, I guess I can put the foot peg back on since it's no longer in the way. This hit so many more roadblocks than it should have, but I'm feeling good now. All right, so there you have it. It is finally, through all that trouble, back together. Next time, we're gonna go ahead and prep the cylinder heads, the pistons, and all that stuff, and get it ready for installation. So be sure to stay tuned for that. Wow, that's only 2 or 3 more videos, and then we can hear this bike run again for the first time in a few years. Hopefully everything will go good. So until next time, we'll see you then.